Hi Navinia, in previous class we have discussed regarding the resources in that we have come across the thing like that power resources, and today class we are going to talk about one more thing, that is hydroelectricity. So we know in the science you may have read about the hydroelectricity, how we are going to convert hydroelectricity. What is the main thing in here means that is from the water we are getting the hydroelectricity. The electricity which is generating from the force of falling water, that is we are calling by the name of hydroelectricity. So when I am saying here, in the previous class I was saying to you that is what are the things will be the resources. Some resources are renewable, some of the non-renewable resources, for example petroleum, coal. We can give example as a non-renewable resources, but when I'm saying the hydroelectricity or water, that is a renewable resources, and it is renewable and cheaper, has higher calorific value than coal and oil, and it keeps machines clean, and it can be easily transmitted. These are the qualities of the hydroelectricity. That is, once again, it is a renewable resources, it's cheaper and higher calorific value than coal and oil. It keeps machine clean. It can be easily transmitted. India does not have any adequate fossil fuels, for example, such adequate we can say coal and natural gas. We don't have that much more. Hence, we need to develop hydel power. Why we need to develop hydel power? The question may arise to you, because India does not have adequate fossils. So, that is a reason we need to develop hydel power. Beside these factors, the favorable for the development hydel power are found in India. So, when is the first hydroelectricity started in India? Where it was started? You may be having a question. So the first hydroelectricity power plant in India was installed in the Darjeeling in West Bengal in the year of the 1897, but real generation of hydro power was started, that is in another than in Karnataka, that is Shivana Samudram on Kaveri River in the year of 1902. The real hydel power station has been worked in India, that is none other than the Shivana Samudra, the river across the river Kaveri. Which are the important hydel power generation stations in India? We can talk here. Karnataka, Shivana Samudra is there, Shimsha, Sharavati, Linganamakki, Alamatti, Varahi, Kali and Badra are the important one. If it goes to Tamil Nadu, Mettur, Paikra, Periyar, Moyarkunda, Suruliyar, Kodiyar, Solayar, Maharashtra, Koyan, Kopil, Bola, Bibupuri and Birha, Odisha, Hirakud, Bhimkat, Bimela and Rageli, Andhra Pradesh, Sri Shailam is there, Ramapada Sagar, Selluru, Telangana, Nizamgarh, Nagarjuna Sagar, Panchampad, Kerala, Kerala I have to tell, it is Idukki, Shabagiri, Pallivasal and Parambikulam. Others I have to tell, that is Ukai, Khandam in Gujarat, Shubarkelam, Meitang, Tialia, Panchathil in Jharkhand, Bakra Nangal in Punjab, Kosi in Bihar, and Gandhi Sagar in Madhya Pradesh. Besides, there are many other hydel power stations are found in the various parts of our country. And next we are going to talk about nuclear power. So the generation of energy from atomic minerals, the generation energy will be generated from the atomic minerals, or we are calling as a nuclear power. In India, demand for energy has increased. However, the production of power is not enough to meet our requirement. So the demand is more, but we are not able to produce more what our requirements. So India is formulated the program of nuclear production. India has the largest atomic minerals, for example uranium and thorium, which required for the generation of nuclear energy. It was also helped the technical know-how. The first nuclear power station that is set up in the Tarapur. This is another place is very important for the map marking. Tarapur in the year of the 1969. Now there are 7 nuclear plants in our country. One already said, the Tarapur. It is near Mumbai in Maharashtra. And Rana Pratapa Sagar, that is Kota, Rajasthan. Kalpakkam near Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Narora in Uttar Pradesh. Kharagpur in Gujarat. Kaiga near Karwar, Karnataka. Kundan Kulam, Tamil Nadu. Once again, I will be repeat. The first nuclear station was established in the year of the 1969 in Tarapur, that is in Mumbai and in Maharashtra. Other totally we are having 7, including Tarapur, Rana Pratapa Sagar near Kota, and Kalpakkam near Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Narora, Uttar Pradesh. Kakrapara in Gujarat. Kaiga near Karwar, that is Karnataka. Kundan Kulam in Tamil Nadu. Why we need non-conventional? We said that conventional and the non-conventional. Why we need the non-conventional energy? What is the reason for this? See, in India, we are having the non-conventional power resources are found in abundance. We are getting the more, okay? But they are renewable, pollution free and eco-friendly. Non-conventional resources are, one is renewable, pollution free and eco-friendly. They can be conveniently supplied to urban as well as rural areas. They are capable for meeting the requirements of power in India. In recent years, rate of energy consumption has increased. That's one more reason. Thus, there is an urgent need to develop alternative power resources in India. So, our energy consumption is more. We are not able to produce that much. There is a reason we have to urgent development of the alternative power resources in India. So, what is the reason for the, what do you mean by energy crisis? We can see what are the reasons for the energy crisis and what the remedies we can take. So, energy crisis is one of the major problem of India, we can tell, in these days. The great demand for energy, but production is not sufficient. Energy is not sufficient. This causes energy crises in the country. An adverse effect of the industrial, agriculture, transport and trade. What is the reasons for this? Main reasons for this, that is the major deposit and shortage of petroleum. Is a deposit and shortage of petroleum is the one reason. Second one is poor quality of coal, erratic rainfall. The rainfall is not distributed everywhere in the sea. Hence, shortage of water for the generation of hydroelectricity. Nowadays, we are not getting the rain properly. That is the reason. One more reason. That is the reason. Loss of power production, process of transmission. Limited use of non-conventional energy. These are the reasons for the energy crisis. I will repeat. One is the major deposit of the shortage of petroleum, poor quality of coal, erratic rainfall, and shortage of water for the generation of hydroelectricity. Loss of power in the process of transmission and limited use of non-conventional resources. What are the remedies we can take? Measures to solve the energy crises. One is the increase the production of petroleum and coal. We have to do this one. Steps taken to have substitute for oil and coal. We have to take the substitutes for that. Importance must be given for increasing water power generation. Greater use of non-conventional sources of energy. What are the remedies? Increase the production of petroleum and coal. Steps to be taken, have substitute for oil and coal. Importance must be given to increase water power generation, greater use of non-conventional sources of energy, This is about the minerals and the power resources of India. Thank you for watching video. Have a great day ahead.